हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई कवर द वेरी फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 12th इंग्लिश विस्तार्स बुक द थर्ड लेवल बाय जैक फिनी। बेसिकली हिज स्टोरीज आर फुल ऑफ थ्रिलर एंड सस्पेंस। लाइकवाइज दिस स्टोरी इज आल्सो हैज लॉट्स ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स, बट आई विल ट्राई टू समराइज इट इन अ वेरी सिंपलेस्ट वे एंड आई होप यू विल अंडरस्टैंड इट। लेट अस सी द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द चैप्टर। This story is all about the harsh realities of wars. War has irreversible consequences, thus leaving among people insecurity. Also, this story is all about the modern day problems and how the common people tend to escape from the reality by various means. Same ways, here in this story, there was a man named Charlie who hallucinates and reaches the third level of Grand Central Station, that is in New York. But in real, that station has only two levels. That is the significance of the title, and that's why this title named the third level. Let us see the main character of the chapter. The first character is of Charlie, who is protagonist of the chapter, and the second one is Sam, who is the securitist, and the third one is Lucia, Charlie's wife. These are the main three characters of the story. Now listen to the summary. The story begins in a mock serious manner. Everyone knows that there are only two levels at Grand Central Station in New York. But Charlie, a 31-year-old guy, asserts that there are three and he had been on the third level. One night, Charlie, an ordinary guy, worked late at night in the office. He was in a hurry to reach home, so he decided to take the subway from Grand Central Station. He turned into Grand Central from the Vanderbilt Avenue and went down the steps to the first level, which one could take trains like the 20th century. Then he walked down the second level where trains left for the suburban areas. Then he decided into an arched doorway heading for the subway and got lost. He had lost his way a couple of times earlier too while taking the subway. Once he entered the lobby of the Roosevelt Hotel, while the other time he emerged at an office building that was three blocks away. But this time, when he loses his way, something unique happens. He visits the third level. Charlie keeps walking in the quiet corridor, angling left and standing downward, till he reaches an architecture really old station that is completely different from the two familiar levels. The antiquated small room with fewer ticket counters and the train gates, a wooden information booth, flickering open flame gas lights and brass spittoons. These all things remind him of the architecture of the 18th century. He also finds that people are dressed in outmoded outfits. He notices that the date on the newspaper, The World, the name of the newspaper is The World, is printed June 11, 1894. Just pay attention towards the date 1894. He turns toward the ticket window and wants to buy two tickets to Galesburg. Since he had no old style currency, he could not buy tickets and came back home. He had always wanted to travel to Galesburg with his wife, Lucia. In his mind, it is a wonderful town still, with big old frame houses, huge lawns, and tremendous trees whose branches meet overhead on the streets. It is a place with long and pleasant summer evenings where people sat out on their lawns, smoked cigars, and talked quietly. So, the next day during lunch, he exchanges $300 for old style bills amounting to some 200 only. The loss doesn't bother him much as he believes that in the Galesburg everything will be cheaper and that he can manage even with a small amount. But he could never again find a corridor leading to the third level. His wife Lucia is worried after knowing all this and asks him not to look for the third level any further. Suddenly, Charlie realizes that his securities friend Sam, with whom he shared his experience, is nowhere to be found. So, he and his wife keep looking for him in the weekend. One day, while fishing with his stamp collection, Charlie comes across a letter that was not there earlier. It bears the postmark on a faded 6-cent stamp with a picture of the President Garfield. The envelope was sent on July 18, 1894 to Charlie's grandfather in Galesburg and is addressed to Charlie. The letter reads that his friend Sam has reached Galesburg and enjoying his life there. His friend Sam also invites Charlie and Lucia to Galesburg. When Charlie goes to the stamp and coin store, he found out that Sam had bought $800 worth of old currency bills to establish his business of hay, feed and grain in Galesburg. The letter was written by Sam, who was Charlie's secretary. And the story got finished. Okay, now I hope you like it and I also